Hi, my name is Jennifer Standley, and I am the outreach coordinator at the UF Entomology Department. And what that means basically is I'm in charge of all of our outreach events. So I do a lot of public speaking, public events. Either I attend almost all of the events, or actually I organize a lot of volunteers to attend those events as well. I have an arthropod petting zoo that I get to care for. So I have all sorts of cool little critters in that arthropod zoo, from tarantulas to scorpions to roaches to all other types of local Florida wildlife as well, depending on the season. So that's a very fun part of the job. A lot of the times our arthropod zoo is a part of our outreach event. So I take the zoo critters out to all the events that people are able to touch them, feel them, and actually see like what an insect is, what an arthropod is. So it's a great thing, and I love it very much. In addition to being an outreach coordinator for the entomology department, I also do research at the entomology department. So my research is I work at the honeybee research and extension lab. And it's an amazing thing because it's my favorite insect in the world. So I study honeybees. My research is quite detailed, but what I do is something called in vitro rearing. In vitro means outside of its natural environment. So I rear honeybees outside of their natural environment, and I rear them in an incubator. The importance of this type of research is it can tell us developmentally how different types of variables might affect the development of honeybees. Museum collections are really important for the work that I do. I use them a lot in my outreach events. I have a lot of different types of penned insects, and so we have some examples of Florida wildlife insects. We have the pollinator insects, we have different types of beetles, so they're really great when one, getting a close-up look at what different types of insects and arthropods look like, but also so that we can help to teach people how to identify these insects as well. So they're really important that I, something that I use as well in my outreach events. What is an arthropod? Well, arthropods have something called an exoskeleton. That means it's their skeleton is on the outside of their body. They also have bilateral symmetry. So that means that, like looking at you or I, equal sides of their body are the same. Also, so we have five different types of arthropods. We have the centipedes, we have millipedes, we have crustaceans are arthropods, believe it or not, insects are arthropods, and also arachnids are arthropods. And there's different things to classify the various arthropods as we go down. Okay, so one of the other important features of arthropods is arthro means, in Latin, jointed. Pod means foot. So it means they have a jointed foot or jointed leg. So this is another very important identifier in arthropods. Why are arthropods important? There's all sorts of things. When we think about arthropods, one is arthropods are crustaceans. So crustaceans are important for sea life. We like to eat crustaceans. We like to eat lobsters, possibly. So this is an aspect that arthropods are important. We have the millipedes and centipedes. They're great for decomposing things in the environment or eating other types of insects. Then we also have insects. Insects are very important, and at the same time, they can also be a pest. And this is where entomology is important, also in pest and control, which is what we're quite familiar with. But insects can be very important as arthropods because, as I mentioned, I study honeybees. And so a lot of insects are important for our agriculture. Honeybees are super important for our agriculture, and so consequently that means the foods that we like to eat. I mean, who likes to eat fruits, vegetables, and nuts? I know I do. So without insects, these types of insects slash arthropods, we wouldn't have a lot of the foods that we like to eat. So this is another important aspect. Also, insects are important for different types of farms. You know, if you've heard of zoos have a lot of different types of animals that might eat insects as well. So we have insect farmers that also raise insects to feed other animals that we're able to care for. How are parks important for arthropods? Parks are super important. We love parks for ourselves, but why are they important for arthropods? Well, they're important because it gives them an environment that they can exist naturally without a lot of human intervention. And also on top of that, it's something, a place for you and I can go and visit these arthropods and see and study them in their natural environment as well.